rolling it. Go ahead with it. Here. Is that good? Can you see yourself?
It seems like it's too close.
There you go. We can't stick it too far out. Motherfuckers are not good. Oh, go ahead, man. Can't just kick a bitch out because she can't cook.
You know, that's why you need more than one bitch. Cause one bitch
can
cook.
They can teach the other one.
Another one likes spin children and rear the children. Another one like to be cater to you.
Arts and crafts.
You know,
be doing crocheting and making garments.
Damn right. That's why you're supposed to have more than one woman. All these women ain't equal in all their talents. Shit. They all equally retarded, but they ain't equal.
Because actually, all that woman stuff that woman's supposed to be doing, a lot of that stuff takes skill. There's some women out there got some skills, man.
Mad skills.
You know, they can make them garments. Some women can just cook a meal that you ain't never seen before. You know what I mean?
None of these hoes. You never know though, cause a lot of these bitches did come from a household that has some decent rearing.
That's probably why they're able to afford college.
Yeah, that's right. And they want to get away from that culture and learn something new in these goddamn fake ass universities. What's that, Timothy Everlearning?
Wait, Everlearning never came to the truth.
Yeah, that's where they go off at. Once they leave these women leave the fucking house. That's where the madness hit them. I mean, most of these households got madness anyway. But there are some of these houses that are decent. Deep. Bitch, somebody going out there home.
Well, they actually got a mother and a father. You
know, right. That was my point.
That right there, that in itself is amazing to even that exists.
Yeah, that's.
You know, I tell my baby's mama all the time. Like, thanks to you, your children will never know what it was to be like to be raised by a mother and a father.
A family.
Family culture, now, they're going to remember that when they get older.
Yeah.
And they're going to hate you for it.
Yeah.
You know?
It's only a blessing if they ain't going to grow up in this society. This shit's
like. Well, you know what I'm saying, though? That's
But they going to, when it's time comes, the spirit going to hit them anyway.
Only a demon would do that to her children and deprive their children of death.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Only a savage. A savage, that's that lamentation bitch.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, you can't get that off your mind, man. That's the scripture of the month.
Every time I look at her, I just see that lamentation scripture.
Yep. Let me read this real quick. You know what? I want to start at one, man. Because the point is down in
bring it all up.
Point is down in six though, but it's just nice, man. It's code three.
Yeah.
Three and one. This is 2 Timothy 3:1. This know also that in the last days, perilous times shall come.
Yeah, we in the last days. Some perilous times we dealing with. You see all this shit that's going on. You got all that racial division going on. You see the KKK was stabbing people with the American flag. Ooh, you got Russia. About to go to war with America. They already got a proxy war going on with Russia using Turkey. Saudi Arabia is about to go up in Syria.
Yeah, it's about to throw
down. I mean, that ain't perilous. If the threat of thermonuclear war ain't perilous, I don't know what it is.
Mm-hmm. To them, it ain't. These people don't
know. Oh, did you hear about the new lice? They got some new lice. It says in like 20 states right now, you can't kill it with the lice killer.
That's crazy.
The soap and shit.
That's bioengineered.
Probably is.
That's engineered. You know,
when we was little, they always told us that you get lice, you clean it with motor oil. That was the hood treatment. Motor oil, boy. Everybody I knew that got lights, that was something in the hood, bro. They used motor oil to kill it.
That's crazy. That's crazy. It's popping off, man. For men, chubby lovers of their own selves, covetous boasters, proud blasphemers.
Ain't that what you see out here, though? That's the only thing that you see. Everybody is in love with they self. It's all, it's an egocentric society.
Yep.
The whole concept of the United States is built upon individualism. Every man for himself. The what he called the survival of the fittest.
Woo, woo.
Hey, that's Darwinism, the survival of the fittest. That's the main doctrine they pushing. Survival of the fittest.
The law of the jungle.
And
but they don't allow you to really be that way out here.
Right, yeah, really.
They lock your ass up, but they do encourage.
But Esau on the top, he doesn't.
Yeah, that's
because,
right.
Because, you know, he's the most
vile.
He's the most devious and subtile of them all.
That's right. Trial, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful and unholy, without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers.
Hey, because truth breakers, hey, you can't take nobody's word. If somebody promises you something, you know what I'm saying? Don't get all bent out of shape when they don't keep their word. You know?
Right,
they ain't gonna keep their word.
Right.
These people's word is worth nothing. It's worth spit. What's the old saying? The man ain't got nothing but his word and his balls.
That's right.
That's an old saying.
That's what Scarface said.
Yeah, Scarface. Hey, because my word is everything. But he said my word is bond, you know?
Yeah.
If I tell you something, you can believe it. Go ahead.
Without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good,
yeah.
Traitors.
Despisers of those that do good. But people will talk all kinds of shit if they see us out here wearing these garments, teaching a Bible on the streets. They're trying to make fun of us. Like, y'all motherfuckers, y'all ain't right.
Yeah, they won't say it to our face, though.
They won't say it to your face, but say it
while they're walking off or something.
I got people do it all the time. Like, people I grew up with, behind, because people tell me things. Little birds tell you things. Little bird
will fly. That's Ecclesiastics.
Yeah. The birds will tell you things, bro.
They talk.
And then I confront people on it, too. You know, like, well, for real, so I'm a bum and shit, right? Okay.
Without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of the Most High.
Yeah, I mean, that's why the porno sites is the top internet sites. You know what I mean? You go up on Alexis, Alexis.com, erase the top websites. The top websites are porno sites.
I bet all of them are porn.
They all got their own account on Pornhub.
I bet all of them got a special video. They probably uploaded it.
Oh, yeah, they did.
They probably the ones that did. My girl's going to see this. Shit.
They sharing it on Facebook.
Right. Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof.
This guy.
From such turn away.
Dude just cheesed ass, bro. Smiled at. He get the biggest cheese I've ever seen.
Lord,
I'll go off and read that again.
For having a form of godliness, now I'm tripping.
It's hard to concentrate.
Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. For of this sort are they which creep into houses and lead captive silly women.
These people, they get misled by these silly ass women.
They showed up just in time.
Yeah, well, that's the spirit of the Lord
right there.
The Lord always does that.
Yep.
He always gives you an example to look at while you're teaching.
Yep. America's right.
You know what I mean?
The American woman. Lenny Kravitz.
Yeah, he
that was before Lenny Kravitz.
Guess who?
American woman. Who?
Guess who?
Yeah. Okay.
He said, American woman.
Yeah.
Stay away from me.
Who originally made it though?
And guess who?
That's you sure?
The name of the band was Guess Who.
I was thinking of somebody. Okay, you would know then.
Yeah.
And that was from the 50s or the 60s, I think.
Probably 60s.
Yeah.
They're all that classic rock shit.
Right. When a woman was somewhat in obedience.
Oh, yeah. If they would have made a new version, if that would have first came out in like the now? It's like, American woman, get away from me. She gave me HIV. You know what I mean? They had to add some new lyrics.
Oh, you ain't lying, HIV. And venereal, oh, my venereal disease.
Yep.
American woman.
And all these women, they think, they call, they women claim to be goddesses. Don't you know the word venereal disease comes from the word Venus, the goddess of love?
Ain't that a bitch? American woman got a venereal disease. American woman.
With the HIV.
Stay the hell away from me. American woman. For of this sort are they which creep into houses and lead captive silly women laden with sin.
Laden with sin. That's some, if any of these hoes went to the, in these other countries, in Saudi Arabia, they chopped their goddamn head off.
They get the fucking flamethrower out.
They had flamethrower you, they was stoning you to death.
Look at this shit. Look at a giant coffin full of fucking dead bones.
Yeah, but and we live in a valley of dry bones. That's all you see is zombies walking around.
It's all the fuck this is. It's a fucking zombie. It's a coffin.
It's the dawn of the
shit,
dead. It's
shaped like a coffin.
Shit. It's the, what's that movie? The Dawn of the Dead, The Walking Dead.
That's all of them, my
the
shit.
The Return of the Living Dead. It's the, all of
the them. Fear of the Living Dead.
The Dire.
Z World.
Oh, yeah.
It goes on and on.
Yeah, because everybody getting amped to watch their autobiography tonight, The Walking Dead.
Yeah, yeah. The new one starts tonight, too.
Yeah.
The new one starts, The Fear Walk starts tonight.
Oh, The Fear Walk.
The Fear Walk starts tonight.
Does it?
Yeah, yeah. And I'm thighs on you, baby. The X-Files is the shit, man.
I still have, I'm a binge watcher. I ain't watching.
Oh, my God. Oh,
I know the Vikings came back out. I'll watch
and
that.
My boo is looking very delicious.
Oh,
she
that's
matured.
My girl.
She matured.
She looked better as she got older.
Oh my God, she's looking delicious.
She really do.
She's
and she's all intelligent.
We have Friday Mix Fart.
Cause ain't none of these hoes got nothing on Scully.
None of them. And lead captive silly women laden with sins. Led away with diverse lusts.
All kind of different lusts. What's the different lusts? Bukkakis, scatting, the animal bestiality, the drugs they be doing. They pop all them pills, Oxycontins. Different nationalities.
The whole table of nations.
What's all that? What's that drugs they be doing? That Molly.
The Molly, yeah.
They be on Molly.
Yeah.
They be sipping on the syrup, they drink, their purple drink. The purple drink's popular right now.
My goodness.
That's all they talk about.
There's no ending, man. That's fucking crazy.
I mean, cocaine, that's just the old time favorite. They always doing that.
The cocaine.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's old shit. Cocaine. Ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. That's these women. You know? Leave home, but come here.
Oh, they go to a well, you know, most universities, the majority population of students in universities is all women. Because this whole society is built against the man.
Totally.
To keep the man down. That's why a man can never get custody of his own children. If a woman could be a whore, divorce a man, she will always get custody.
Yeah, they'll favor you if you got big millions.
Well, if you got millions.
Right, if you got
millions. That's because the courts operate on fuck you, pay me.
Right.
That's the principle they operate on.
Exactly.
It's like the Goodfellas, fuck you, pay me.
No exaggeration, too.
That's exactly how it goes down.
Yeah.
I mean, if you pay the courts money, I mean, they'll pretty much do what you want. They'll rule in your favor.
Damn right. The attorney, the judge, all the motherfucking prosecutor. That's some oath breakers for you. That's some oath takers for you.
It ain't shit constitutionalist about the courts. You know, people always talk about, oh, the Constitution, America.
Oh,
all this, man, you people live in fantasy land.
Oh, shit. You see that video, Apostle Tahar put up, Prisoners of Hope. Ain't nobody seen that?
How old is it?
She just put it up.
I didn't see it then.
All these jakes is just pleading for the system and pleading for you to fight for Trump, because they saying, someone was saying Trump is going, he's for the Constitution.
Whatever that means.
You, right, there you go.
I don't know what that means.
I'm tripping too, you know. I have no clue. I have no clue. And this was Jakes that was on the camera fighting for this nation to be great again, you know. That's what they're in their mind.
But it wasn't. I'm trying to find out what period where did that greatness happen.
Yeah, right.
As somebody posted something somewhere on the internet and posted a picture of like a family back in the 30s living in a shack made out of like some scrap metals.
The Depression.
And it said, make America great again.
The Depression.
Yeah.
Let me see if I can find something.
So that's the greatness.
That Depression. That Great Depression ain't shit compared to what's about to happen.
Yeah, they do be talking all kind of shit about Donald Trump, though. He came out, he was talking shit about Jews. Because you know, with Jews, you lose. You see that shit come out on Mark Rubio? How he was going to homosexual swimming pool parties? They got pictures of him up in the swimming pool, all kind of faggots, butt naked. So he going up to them homosexual cocaine drug parties, worshiping Satan. That's what all the politicians do, man. I hope we don't even make it to the election. I hope the elections get canceled.
Man, you know, that's what I'm counting on. If they do, is get canceled. So we're going to piss these people off even more.
I can't stand election season. That's all the fuck they talk about on the radio and TV.
Why can't you give my dad a job?
Get that on camera. Get that going there.
These are photos from the Great Depression during the late 20s, 30s.
Bring it up a little bit. There you go. Back.
Why can't you give daddy a job?
And that's another thing. Yeah, people always want somebody else to give them a job. They always beg to be the servant. Because our people don't have that ruling class mentality. They got the mentality of a servant and a slave. They're willing, you know, to be someone else. That they begging, always begging the government for more jobs. Which... a job to be an employee means you're somebody's servant.
Oh shit, world's highest standard of living. There's no way like the American way. Oh shit.
Oh shit. America.
America. Oh shit.
I fucking hate this country, man.
I love it.
Yeah. I mean, really.
I love to see this motherfucker get destroyed.
Exactly. Because you really do love it. This is the Most High's handiwork right here. Mm-hmm. You can see that we deserve to be put in this shit.
Yeah, yeah. It was worthy. We were worthy of getting
told. Yeah, we deserve this.
Yeah. And it takes a man his right state of mind to be aware of that.
You understand? Because look at our people, man. Our people are filthy. They just the filthiest people on the earth, man.
Yeah, starting with the women.
They the first ones to take that fruit.
That's right.
Bring it out. What was your question? I got a script.
I ain't got no fucking tissue. Oh, yes, sir, I do.
I don't know. I got a preset, bro.
You said you don't know. Don't say you don't know, bro. What you out here for?
Yeah. Oh, all things.
Oh,
that's good, because our presence out here vexes their spirit. They can't believe somebody has the audacity to come out here and speak freely.
No audacity. To come out here and speak against America?
Against America?
America? America?
The land of the free?
from this vexed scripture.
I got a scripture. If I can get it. It's blowing my pages all over the place. Get my James. Do I got a James in here? James might have got blown out of there.
Here you go. This is Ezekiel 32:8. All the bright lights of heaven will I make dark over thee, and set darkness upon thy land, said the Lord Power. I will also vex the hearts of many people, when I shall bring thy destruction among the nations, and to the countries which thou hast not known. Yea, I will make many people amazed at thee. Like you said, coming out here, vexing the shit out of these motherfuckers. Just our presence alone.
I got a precept for that too.
And their kings shall be horribly afraid for thee, when I shall brandish my sword before them, and they shall tremble at every moment, every man for his own life in the day of thy fall. See, they don't want to hear about these future prophecies, man. It vexes them.
It does vex them.
So our presence, they hate the presence of a man that's going to come out here and do it openly, you know. They prefer to do it at home on a computer or, you know.
Because really, it's just like John 3:18 or something like that. It said, I should just get it, man. Hey, get John 3:18.
That's what I was getting.
While you get that, I'm going to read this. 1 Corinthians 1:18. For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness. But unto us which are saved, it is the power of the Most High. You see that? Because they looking at us like, we some fools and shit. Because we know this is the power right here.
And we know we fools.
For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise and will bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent. Where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Now this is the point. Where is the disputer of this world? Have not God made foolish the wisdom of this world?
Oh, it's you.
And all the other, what's that? They main wisdom. Oh, ain't tonight the Oscars?
Oh, no.
I think it is. Oh, but that's their main wisdom.
The one that Chris Rock is hosting.
Yeah.
They're making a big deal out of that.
Because you know, if you know all the names of all the actors and movie directors, they be like, man, he's real. This dude's smart, man. This is the smartest dude I know. Man, he's deep. I mean, I never, you gotta meet my friend. He knows all the actors' names. Or if you know somebody who knows everybody's stats, they gonna come out, oh, LeBron, he averaged 29.5 points or something. You know, they be like, oh, this motherfucker's smart.
I can't begin to tell you.
Man, what kind of knowledge is that? That shit is irrelevant. We keep going. For after that, in the wisdom of God, the world by wisdom knew not God. It pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. That's the point.
Put us out here to do just that, teach these fools.
Yep.
They can't say we weren't out here.
I mean, Lord willing, some of these fools will wake up out of these trance. Because the devil, you know what I'm saying? Esau done got these people under a magical spell. With all their propaganda, all that TV and music they listen to, it puts people in a magical spell. They in a trance. That's what they under. They ain't in a trance. That's why the Lord said it's high time to wake your ass out of sleep.
That's right. With the three still. This is John 3:18. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already.
Yeah, so if you don't believe in the truth, you condemned. So we're not concerned with you. Keep on.
Right.
Yeah, why?
Because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of the Most High, Yahweh. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light.
Right. That's why they got a problem with it, because they love darkness rather than the light. There's no truth in them. The average person, they don't care about truth and what's right. What's the right thing to do? What's really true? What matters? They don't care about loving their brother, loving their neighbor.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
They don't care about that.
There's no one cares for them.
Feed me lies. That's what they say. They say we have no king but Caesar.
Oh, bring them on.
like your boy on the Matrix. He said, ignorance is bliss. Put me back in the Matrix. He said, let me be an actor.
Yeah, yeah. Just like that experiment the Russians did when the people were sleep deprived. Probably.
Yeah.
The ones that went through the test, they wanted to wake them up, so they gave them the drug to wake them up. But these people wanted to go right back into that state of mind where they was, you know, in the video, you know, the video showed the people was tearing their skin off,
damn,
eating, you know, eating themselves, and they wanted to go back into that state of mind, man. They'll be waking back up to this reality again, man. That's a badass documentary that the Russians made, man. Let me find this scripture on the
TV. I don't think I've seen that.
Yeah, it's bad as hell, man.
Proverbs 29:27. The unjust man is an abomination to the just, and he that is upright in the way is an abomination to the wicked.
Yeah, because we look at people, they eat pork, they all fat and nasty and stupid and retarded and just talking all kind of gibberish and foolishness. We look at them like it ain't an abomination, but when we come out here and try to educate these fools, teaching them knowledge and teaching them about truth and what's right, they look at that like we're abominable, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like there's something wrong with us because we were dealing with facts, dealing with truth. People get pissed at me all the time, my family. Yeah, because they start talking about anything. Because you know I'm the type of guy, if you say something wrong, I'm going to correct you. Like, oh, hold on a minute. You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah, people hate that correcting.
Like, nah, I ain't going to let you slide.
If that's your person. Even if they wrong.
Oh, yeah.
Even if they just wrong. And even if the information that you correct them on could benefit them, they still take that shit.
Yeah, still, yeah. It's that pride.
Yeah. And that's why we out here to try to turn correct the people.
What's that?
Nobody wants to
what's
be corrected.
About swallows a gnat.
Ooh.
I'm gonna look for that.
You can do a search.
I got it.
Here we go. This is Isaiah 9. Did you have something? Okay. 9:14. Therefore the Lord will cut off from Israel head and tail, branch and rush in one day. The ancient honorable, he is the head, and the prophet that teacheth lies, he is the tail. The leaders.
Yeah, all them fools up in them churches. You know what I'm saying? They on the bottom. They gonna get fucked up.
Right. For the leaders of this people cause them to err. And that includes the woman.
Well, that's their top leader right now. There is no men leaders no more.
None.
Everybody looking for women as leaders now.
Right.
They put women, because the roles have been reversed. You know what I'm saying? That's men right. Are now women.
Yep. The Most High created a new thing.
Yep, like, was that gender freak? Oh, yeah, I seen a Drudge Report today. They said it was some kind of movie, an indie movie awards, and a transsexual won Best Actress.
I didn't even read it.
I didn't read it either.
I saw it though.
I read the headline. I couldn't even click on it.
Yeah, right.
I didn't want to see no more.
Yep. Didn't want to. Right. You just.
Oh, you want the ass crack? I had some fools. I was arguing with somebody yesterday. They kept trying to. They was on these forums, and it was a popular forum too. This had all kind of posts on it.
Right.
And it, what the whole thing was, they was teaching that the God of the Bible was actually the female, was a goddess. No, it was mostly women posting up in there saying that shit. And people was eating it up like, yeah, because the woman's more nurturing. And so that's just, and people believe it. But every time you see Yahweh Shai talking about the Most High in the New Testament, what does he say? He says, Father,
my father.
Abba, my father. I mean, so you believe that, you're retarded. I mean, every day you see some new kind of new madness. Some new crazy ass doctrine.
Yeah, that's that man that's in all the Bibles they want to make, man. Gay Bibles, women Bibles, children Bibles, satanic Bibles.
Yeah, they mixing all that new age shit up in it.
Yeah, yeah.
Which all goes back to the worshiping of the goddess.
Let me finish reading this, Isaiah.
Because you really look at it, America's under the spiritual vibration of the goddess.
That's right.
You know
that's
what I mean?
That's go. Right, guys. Yeah. Oh, there's somebody, two men down there where we park at.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Hold hands kissing.
Oh, that's fucking foul.
Off the whole hands.
You know, even the word America, that's a feminine. Because you know, America is a Latin word, right?
America.
Well, yeah. Even though it actually comes from Hebrew,
yeah.
Even though it comes from Hebrew, you got, you know, mar. It means bitter. But when you put an A at the end of a word, that makes it feminine. That's why they always refer to as a her. They got a Statue of Liberty.
That's why she's that stinking whore in Revelation.
Yep. That's why on the top of the Capitol building, the Capitol Hill, they got a statue of the goddess right on top of the Capitol Hill. They call her Lady Liberty, which is really just the goddess. You know, Semiramis.
Statue of Liberty is a fucking
transsexual. Yeah.
That shit crazy. What's that for God, man?
Oh, you talking about it looks like Elgabus.
Yeah.
Remember, there was a Roman emperor. He was the son of Caracalla, which was the grandson of Septimius Severus. But so he's probably a Jake though.
Earlier time.
Yeah, well in about the year 200 or something. But yeah, Elagabus. He was a pretty much a transsexual Roman emperor. And he worshiped Sol Invictus. Mm. I mean that's what the Statue of Liberty is, just a transsexual Sol Invictus is what it is.
Mm-hmm. That's madness, man. That is complete madness. You can't make this shit up, man. This whole goddamn nation is a nation of
faggots and filth.
The whole nation.
That's my favorite word to refer to these people is filth.
The whole nation. God.
It's a nation of filth and perverseness.
Yeah. The whole nation. On steroids. This is Solomon. On steroids.
On steroids.
Mm-hmm. Here we go. For the leaders of this people caused them to err, and they that are led of them are destroyed.
And that goes to the preachers, the pastors, and even the politicians, all the leaders.
Therefore, the Lord shall have no joy in their young men, neither shall have mercy on their fatherless and widows. For everyone is a hypocrite and an evildoer.
That's what you see. All these people are hypocrites, man.
How you gonna come out there and preach hate when they ain't nothing but hate?
What, yeah, they always talking about, why you out there cussing, holding a Bible, motherfucker?
And all the
you know, that's how they do you.
Fuck you guys. You know, right.
He was cussing us out and drinking.
Yeah, cussing, getting drinking.
Mm-hmm.
Probably just committed adultery and committed every sin under the sun. And then they gonna talk shit to us.
Right. And that demon was, he was like out drunk. You know? He had to get drunk to open his mouth.
You gotta get some
scripture
courage.
Says don't be out here all like that, man. Oh, drunk ass demon. Therefore the Lord shall have no joy in their young men, neither shall have mercy on their fathers and widows, for every one is an hypocrite and an evildoer, and every mouth speaketh folly. Everyone. Every mouth speaketh foolish. Everyone.
That's all, you know, how often do you hear wisdom?
The only
The only time I hear any words of wisdom is from y'all.
It's right here.
That's it.
You literally don't hear it.
I mean, some people, you know, you got 1/3 who ain't part of the elect. They might say something to make sense every once in a while. You know what I mean? Hit you. You know, there's some Jakes out there got a little wisdom. But it's very few and far between.
Talking about sense.
But for the most part, you just getting hood knowledge, ghetto knowledge.
That's it. Or jailhouse
some
wisdom.
Some jailhouse wisdom.
Yeah, because you know a motherfucker been killed for doing time. He coming out thinking he an attorney. You know?
Yeah, that's they do. Jake always talk about he an expert on the law.
Mm-hmm.
Just because he done broken the law so many times. He knows exactly how much shit he can steal from the store before he gets a felony. He know, you know, and they'll go right up to like a dollar short of it.
You know some gas shit. He Jakes, they be bragging about you know, you get go to jail, they check you, you got bent over and stuff.
Yeah,
they stick in their ass.
They was bragging about that shit. They
get
like,
away from people.
Yeah. Could I be smoking weed in jail? Like, how you get that?
When you go
I was
jail,
in my ass.
Yeah, when you go, when they check you in, even if you got misdemeanors or anything, don't matter. Change from your clothes to your I can't remember the colors they wear down there.
Talking about they make you bend over.
I had them on so many times. I still don't remember the colors they put on. Well, anyway, they have you. They pull your dick and shit up. And that's the cop is sitting there looking at you. And until you turn around, bend over, open your cheeks. Until you do all that shit.
And all them guards up in the prisons and jails. They crooked. They sell. They bringing drugs and all kind of shit up in
yeah,
there.
Yeah, that's what's doing it. That's
you know
doing
what I mean?
Mm-hmm. COs and shit. Just a few days ago, some COs just got busted for. Well, actually, they catching this shit all over the country, man. Motherfuckers bringing drugs into the prisons, man.
And they be raping male prisoners too, mm-hmm. Women prisoners. They raping everybody.
See, my brother, before he got fired from his prison job, his job was to transport prisoners to various places around the city to do their job.
It's like a horrible draft.
You know, while they out and about. My wicked ass brother was doing this with him. He was hooking them up too, you know, taking shit right back to the jailhouse. That's how it gets there. This is the COs cooperate.
Hey, let me get this scripture. Psalms 14 and 1.
What's up, man?
They have done abominable works. There is none that doeth good. None. The Lord looketh down from heaven upon the children of men to see if there were any that did understand and seek the Most High. They are all gone aside. They are all together become filthy. There is none that doeth good. No, not one.
No, not one. Just like in the days of Noah, Noah was the only righteous man around for him to say Noah's house.
Yep.
It was just Noah's house.
Noah. Just like when the Most High got destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, he told Abraham, like, you go find me 100 righteous men. And when he went through the whole deal, like, if it went all the way down, just find me one righteous
right,
man.
Right.
The only that's one right. That got saved was Lot.
It's just rare, man. It's just a rare thing. Unfortunately. Well, that's a terrible feeling, man, to be.
Oh, and since Lot was vexed by the conversation of the wicked.
Yeah.
This thing, the mad shit, he had shit. One of, we feel Lot. You know?
That's why it's so easy for me to keep my ass in the house, man.
Well, because you get vexed by these people out here, man. They vex your spirit. You don't want to be around a bunch of rats and roaches all the time.
Right. Especially your own family, like the males, your brothers or your uncles and shit, man. Can't go around them motherfuckers because they stuck on fucking stupid, man.
They stuck on stupid.
Now you tell me you ain't supposed. You supposed to. You go supposed to be around elders, and an elder is supposed to be an elder because he's an elder because he's speaking as an elder.
You're supposed to have that wisdom and knowledge,
right?
But they ain't got none.
They don't exist, man.
That's like I was arguing with my brother this weekend. I was trying to hit some truth of knowledge, which big mistake.
He's older than you.
Nah, he's younger. But he's going on talking about some Neil deGrasse Tyson, and that's where the knowledge was at.
Oh, the scientists?
Yeah. I'm like, because they don't believe nothing is true unless it's on that TV.
Yeah, right.
You know, if the TV didn't say it, it ain't true.
That's right.
But peep this out. Neil deGrasse Tyson said the earth was shaped like a pear, right? Did you hear him say that? Get on YouTube, type in Neil deGrasse Tyson, earth shaped like pear. So if, according to him, the earth is shaped like a pear, then how come all the pictures of the planet earth, they're all a perfect circle? Break that down to me. Explain that.
Yeah, I heard him say a lot is oblong.
Explain it. Because all those pictures of Earth are all fake. They're paintings.
You they can't go far out, hell far no. enough out there to take a picture, man.
Man, I was watching a video on YouTube, and somebody was up in an airplane and looked down in the clouds and see the sun underneath them in the airplane. That's bugged out. So they don't even know where the sun is at. Astronauts went up out wherever they went out there.
They couldn't find it.
They was looking everywhere for the sun and couldn't find it.
Couldn't find it. Make some sense out of that.
Yeah, make some sense out of that.
Couldn't find it. Shit. They go out there sometimes, can't even see stars and shit.
Exactly.
You know?
They don't know what stars are. Talking about their suns. Okay.
They don't have a clue. Don't listen to them goddamn devils.
Until, yeah, if they know so much, how come they ain't created their own solar system yet? You know what I'm saying? I mean, they know it. I mean, they know how it was created.
Like,
you should be able to order your own solar system.
Yeah, they do tell you step by step.
Step by step.
Yeah, This is Job 32:9. Great men are not always wise.
Yeah, great men are not always wise. Oh yeah, just like people always think that the Native American, they got, if they're an old American, Native American with a feather in their head, that's the greatest wisdom. They start talking about the ant people coming out the ground. You know what I'm saying? And they believe all that. That's some old, yeah, that's some old wives' tales, man.
I'm telling you, it's an old motherfucker to open his mouth. Man.
Yeah. It's just because he's old, toxic, broken English, and got a feather in his head. That's wisdom.
Right, right. Neither do the aged understand judgment.
Them Hopi elders, boy. Yeah, hey, look at these old fools out here. You got a bunch of old fools out here. A bunch of old wine bags. A bunch of old bags.
Dumbasses.
Don't know their ass from a hole in their pants.
Goddamn fake ass honorable men.
Yeah. Some great Americans.
Great Americans. Motherfuckers ain't shit.
They really ain't shit.
These people ain't shit.
They likened unto a mountain of shit. A mountain of dung.
That's right.
Hey, I gotta get this scripture. The Lord likened them unto dung. I'm about to do a scripture search on dung.
That's right.
Go ahead.
Wisdom of Solomon 4:8. For honorable age is not that which standeth in length of time, not that is nor that is measured by number of years, but wisdom is the gray hair unto men, and an unspotted life is old age. For honorable age is not that which standeth in length of time, nor that is measured by number of years.
There you go.
But wisdom is the gray hair unto men, and an unspotted life is old age.
That's right, because the Lord was 32, and he was completely gray. Beard and all that, man. You ain't the smartest motherfucker just cause you made it to 87 fucking degrees. I mean, 87 years old. If you can live that goddamn long.
You got old retarded people.
Old retarded, that's right. Old ass stupid motherfuckers, man. And I'm telling you now, man. My whole family, all my older brothers is the most dumbest motherfuckers you can possibly think of, man. Can't teach you shit. Can't teach you a motherfucking thing, man.
I know grown ass men that can't read.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I don't know how the fuck they get by.
Yeah, my kid's mom, her dad, he's a mason, but she does his bills for him. Yeah. Even to this day, man, she does his bills, write the checks and everything. You know, does everything.
Yeah.
And I guess he gives her whatever, but she's been doing it ever since I've known that bitch, man.
But half the teenagers in these public schools, they can't read. I've seen their handwriting, everything. You know what I mean? A lot of these young teenagers. I mean, they're retarded.
Yeah, somebody told me that they don't require you to write in cursive. They don't teach it. It's not required to teach in cursive anymore.
I hate cursive anyway, so I'm with that one. You try to write that Z? I don't know. I still can't do a Z. Cursive? I'm the type of guy that writes in all caps. Hey, ancient Hebrews is only one case, bro. All caps. That's why Jake be on the comic board is like a madman in all caps. A paragraph, my ass. They write you a whole. They write you a short story in a novel.
And it's only
and you can't read that shit being all caps.
Yeah.
It'd be hard.
I mean, actually, I'd rather see it, though.
Yeah.
Plus, it's better for me to read. I guess because my eyesight going bad.
Because you know when somebody start raging, they go all caps.
All caps. Some of them just don't know, like dumbass, dumb motherfucker who be on GMS their videos.
It's always the haters in all caps.
The retarded dude, yeah, yeah.
It's always the retarded motherfuckers in all caps. They got no, they can't,
they don't know.
Can't
they don't
spell
know.
For shit.
They call something.
I mean, you got a spell checker and motherfuckers still can't spell.
It still comes out wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right, right.
Don't even let me get on people. They still don't know how to do the yours and the your. And the theirs, and theirs.
That nigga love his heat.
Hey, I got a scripture.
Just like Jake. I was going to finish that up.
I'll go ahead.
Isaiah. Therefore the Lord shall have no joy in their young men, neither shall have mercy on their fathers and widows. For every one is an hypocrite and an evildoer, and every mouth speaketh folly. For all this, his anger is not turned away, but his hand is stretched out still.
Yeah.
before, yeah, because that door is closing, though. It's closing.
I mean, that's the whole reason we're out here teaching.
Right.
Because remember, the Lord said that he's the whoever knocking, he's the door, was that?
Yeah, there you go.
I'm going to see if I can find it. That's in Revelation, what, 2 and 3?
Yeah, right now, the Lord is stretching out forth his arms. Yeah. Now, it's up to y'all, people out here, that, if y'all want to embrace him or not. Hey, brother, this is for you, man. You know you're an Israelite? You know you're an Israelite? That's your nationality. You're an Israelite. That's the Lord stretching out for you, telling you.
Look,
that's an example.
I got a perfect precept for that. Revelation 3 and 19. As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten. Be zealous, therefore, and repent. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. And if any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and sup with him, and he with me.
And that's these people walking by. If they hear, it ain't the Lord physically coming to your damn crib.
It's the door in your mind.
It's the, right, that's right. That's right. The spirit.
Yep, your spirit.
You know, pass the porch, I'll turn it into, I'll be at your crib. You know what time your husband leave? You know what I'm saying? What time your husband leave, I'll be there to teach
well,
the Lord.
According to the Pope, the Pope calls himself the Holy Father.
Oh, he sure does.
And you guys to go through him to even get to the Lord. You know
that's
what I mean?
Right.
And that's the biggest Christian church on the earth. And let me get the rest of this. To him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne. Hey, that's the point.
There we go. For wickedness burneth as the fire. Hold on. Before I can finish that. Let me go to Proverbs. Go to Proverbs.
Boy, he's getting it though. Yeah, he was gone with it. Yeah, he got it, bro. You didn't even see Esau floating like that. He looked like he was going about 50 miles an hour on that thing. He already down the street.
I wonder if he got a Bible fucking skateboard too.
He's probably late for his Bukkake.
Right. Homosexual Bukkake.
Yes.
Here we go. This is Proverbs 1 and 23. Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you.
Yep.
I will make known my words unto you. And that's through us.
He is, man. He ain't lied, did he?
Look at the dude with the shirt coming down there.
Yeah. We sent him earlier.
That's the same. Remember I told you about the truck?
But that's the upright one, though.
Well, the same shit.
It's
though.
The same
it
shit.
It don't matter how it turns, it's the same shit.
Depends. If you upside down, it'll look different. It's the same shit. Sorry.
And he's fine. What's the question, man?
He might be cool.
Let's find out if he's willing to wear that shit.
Yeah, you don't know.
Hey, excuse me. You got your question?
I ain't worried about that. One look at him and know he's a goner. Zephaniah 1. Let me get this. Zephaniah 1 and 14. The great day of the Lord is near. It is near and hasteneth greatly. Even a voice of the day of the Lord, the mighty man shall cry there bitterly. That day is a day of wrath, a day of trouble and distress, a day of wasteness and desolation, a day of darkness.
That's
your boy.
That's the one who called the cops and cops.
Yeah.
Him to go down there. You know?
That's actually, I ain't worried about him. He's a joke.
That's the one right there. That's the one. The book I got. He was observing that the one with his wife and how filthy they were. He had his clothes on so long and the clothes.
Oh, that, was that his 13th tribe or the other
the
one?
13th tribe. That was it. Fossler, yeah. Kosler, Arthur
yeah.
Kosler.
Yeah, that's an awesome book.
That's a bad book, man.
Yeah,
that's awesome. A bad book, man. I'm willing to buy a few copies for brothers, man, just to have that book, man.
And that's the same thing General Patton said about him.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, let me get this though. I was feeling the scripture. I'm going to read this. Let's just start at 15. Zephaniah 1 and 15. That day, we're talking about the day of the Lord. That day is a day of wrath, a day of trouble and distress, a day of wasteness and desolation,
day of the Lord.
A day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness, a day of the trumpet and alarm against the fenced cities and against the high towers. And I will bring distress upon men, that they shall walk like blind men, because they have sinned against the Lord. And their blood shall be poured out as dust, and their flesh as the dung, which is shit.
Check it out. During that time, you're going to hear those alarms. You're going to hear those alarms. Because when they push them buttons, man, them alarms
they
going to
have the bomb sirens and all that.
Yeah, all the everything's going to be going off. And them alarms is loud as shit, man. They're all over the cities.
You're going to be hearing screams.
Yep. They're all over the cities.
And then the traffic's going to be backed up to hell. Because everyone's trying to make it out to cities.
That's right.
Running for the hills.
Yep. Military motherfuckers gonna be going around snatching people up.
Yep.
Taking them to the nearest concentration camp. Detainment center.
You know, they in the prisons, they got a protocol in the prisons. If there's a nuclear attack, it's the guards gotta kill everybody in the prison.
I see it coming. Gonna do a number on the wicked. That's what he's going to do. He's going to do a number on the wicked. Should have listened.
Hey, let me read the rest of this. 7:1-18. Neither their silver nor their gold shall be able to deliver them in the day of the Lord's wrath, but the whole land shall be devoured by the fire of his jealousy.
Boom.
For he shall make even a speedy riddance of all of them that dwell in the land. Talking about this land. He gonna make a speedy riddance of all these fools out here.
Damn skip. How long it take to build this sorry ass place, man? This waste.
Hundreds of years.
Yeah, that's right. And the Most High is gonna destroy it in an hour.
In an hour.
That's right.
All this gonna be turned to dust. All these buildings are gonna be leveled. There ain't gonna be no more sidewalks. Ain't gonna be no adulterous women, no faggots. Y'all gonna get turned into dust.
That's right. Sodomites too.
Well, this is the land of Sodom.
Identity thieves too.
Identity thieves especially.
Identity thieves.
Those are the worst.
For this is back to Isaiah 9:18. For wickedness burneth as the fire. It shall devour the briars and thorns, and shall kindle in the thickest of the forest. And they shall mount up like the lifting up of smoke. Through the wrath of the Lord of hosts is the land darkened, and the people shall be as the fuel of the fire.
So y'all just like walking around, you're like logs you put on a fire. You little sticks and twigs. That's all you are.
No man shall spare his brother, and he shall snatch on the right hand and be hungry, and he shall eat on the left hand, and they shall not be satisfied. And they shall eat every man the flesh of his own arm.
Yeah, because when all hell breaks loose and the shit hits the fan, there ain't gonna be no food in the grocery stores. Hey, I was at Kroger's last night. They shut the EBT down. People was freaking out. Soon they gonna shut the EBT off, and there's gonna be cannibalism out here.
Ooh-wee.
It's gonna happen.
It's beautiful.
It's gonna happen.
That's right. And we praying for it to happen tonight.
We pray for it to happen.
Tonight.
We pray to the
now.
The Lord hasten it. Oh, I'm gonna get Habakkuk.
Have that shit happen now. Here you go. This is Peru 2. Let me start at 1. Therefore the Lord hath made good his word, which he pronounced against us.
Hello.
And against our judges that judged Israel, and against our kings, and against our princes, and against the men of Israel and Judah, to bring upon us great plagues, such as never happened under the whole heaven, as it came to pass in Jerusalem, according to the things that were written in the law of Moses, that a man should eat the flesh of his own son and the flesh of his own daughter.
That's going to happen. You know, over half the American population depends on the government to feed them.
EBT cards.
EBT. None of y'all know how to grow plants or the harvest crop.
Hell, they can't even slaughter their own bird or chicken or whatever.
They can,
you know?
They can barely make macaroni and cheese out of a box.
Should be all dry.
You know they don't. They can't skin a buck.
Right,
you know
right,
what I mean?
Right, right. Hell yeah, you gotta cut the head, drain the blood, take the guts, all that, man.
Y'all can't expect, you know the woman can't do that. Hell. The woman can't even change a tire.
Yeah.
So what's she gonna do?
Ain't no honor. The woman back in the ancient times did all that.
Yeah.
Slaughtered the chicken and all that, man. They did all that. Ain't no man was going to, I mean, he may have done it if he chose to.
I mean, yeah, they'd chop, they'd pop that chicken head, break that chicken's neck, bam! Nice.
Who was that who cut the king's head off and brought it with her?
The king's head? Judith.
Judith. Yeah.
She
was accustomed. She was used to it.
They probably had really a nice like blade, too.
You know? Sharp
probably
enough.
Cut yep. like butter.
Yep. None of these hoes gonna do that. None of the men gonna do it.
Nah.
None of them.
Shit, the scripture said we're gonna take Esau's babies and smash them against the stone.
Shh.
That's right. We're gonna do them like you break a chicken's neck.
I can't stand the sight of that disgusting ass creature, man.
Yeah, he's just a low-level troglodyte.
Foul motherfucker. Foul-ass piece of shit.
I mean, Esau's a low-life.
Look at him, man. He's just got a foul. Look at his vibration, man.
Look at him on camera.
Look at his aura, man. Look at him. I know he stinks. I know he stinks.
I don't know if I got him or not, but.
I know he stinks.
I've already smelled him. I see him all the time when I drive through Bexley.
Oh, you see that?
I always see him out in Bexley.
Right.
Just moping around, looking all retarded.
Right.
I drive through Bexley. Bexley. Driving through Bexley vexes my spirit. It should be called Bexley. It all does is vexes your spirit. You drive through there, you see that synagogue. They got synagogues all over the place. Yeah, they got that big ass synagogue with the Hebrew written on it. It says the laws, the Torah is the truth on it in Hebrew. Then you see them dirty ass rabbis walking down the street with their doo-doo curls. Oh, you know what? I heard a Jew said the reason they got them doo-doo curls because they interpret the scripture says, thou shalt not mar the corner of thy beard. And that's where they get the doo-doo curls. Go ahead. That's retarded. Only a retard would do some shit like that. You know what I mean?
It's amazing.
A heathen would do something like that. That's only a heathen custom, is to grow doo-doo curls on the side of your face.
Yeah, I read that you ask them motherfucking rats a question, they're supposed to give you the wrong answer anyway.
Yeah, they do that.
Yeah.
That's why they'll
That's
never...
That's actually in their satanic Babylonian book they call it.
Oh, in the Talmud it says that. Yeah. It tells you it's permissible to lie to the goyim.
There you go.
And then, and to kill and rob them.
It's probably an anal worm or something, you know?
Yep.
It's something sick.
I'll go ahead with it.
2 Ezra 6:22. And suddenly shall the sung places appear unsung. The full storehouses shall suddenly be found empty.
Ooh, wow.
Yeah, them storehouses, they already get empty.
Yeah, you look at the riots in Venezuela that's going on right now, man.
Oh yeah, they stand in an hour long lines.
It's gotten worse.
Just to get a couple cans of food.
Yeah, a bag of rice or something.
And they having the fingerprint shit so somebody won't get too much more product.
Yep.
It's getting closer to the market.
Here we go. Prophecies.
It is getting closer to the market.
Prophecies.
You know the Kroger grocery store? Kroger's? All the employees that work at Kroger's are clocking in now. They got to do it with their fingerprint.
Wow. What?
Yeah.
Damn.
I see them do it all the time, clocking in and out with their
fingerprint.
I heard
somebody talking about it though, but. That's good.
You ain't gonna see me working a Kroger.
One step closer.
You know,
it ain't the chip though.
But you know, that
it
still might
chip,
be.
Though.
But that's still going in a database.
Yeah,
just like
good.
Even when you use a Kroger card, that's why every store you shop at is owned by a major corporation. They want you to get the Speedway card, the Kroger card, the CVS card, so they can track every last thing you purchase and buy, so they can build a profile on you.
That's right.
They can find out all your weaknesses just by the products you buy. You know? Go ahead.
Verse 23. The trumpet shall give a sound, which when every man hear, they shall suddenly be afraid. Like, America's under attack.
Yeah. if the electric's on, motherfucker gonna have the TV on and shit. America's just been nuked in Austin.
Oh, but nuke hat? Oh, man. Well, you know, they say there was that nuke came up missing back in, what, 2007?
Yeah.
Is that when that happened?
That was just one of many.
One of many, yeah. I mean, that's one. They keep talking about it in the news.
They keep coming up. They keep mentioning it. They keep coming up.
There's another nuke that came up. It was out like a year ago down in Sarah with Lindsey Graham or something. That was like a couple years ago. I can't remember. Time flies by so quick, I can't remember. I'll talk about a story that came out in the news a while back. It was 5 years ago.
Yeah, time is flying, man. Time is flying.
But really, 5 years ain't shit. God. That's just a blink of the eye.
Dang. We've been doing the work longer than that out here. That ain't nothing, man. And it seems like it was nothing.
Come on, you guys.
At that time, saw friends fight one another against like, in that time shall friends fight one against another like enemies, and the earth shall stand in fear, and those that dwell therein, springs of the fountains shall stand still, and in 3 hours they shall not run.
There you go. They fighting against each other now. They been fighting against each other, man. All you have to do is leave the house and find out this motherfucker was sleeping with your woman. You know? But wait till this time comes when this motherfucker's gonna be starving. Because that's the whole purpose of the Most High coming back. He's going to starve a lot of people. You know that? You know the Lord, who they call Jesus, coming back to... He's hoping people get starved out.
They're going to be cannibalism.
Family. Cannibalism.
A lot of them hoes that got them thick, fat asses, they be looking at it like a honey-baked ham.
Ooh, yes, they
do. You know what I mean?
Look at them. See them pissing. See that?
Oh, she got so much fat, they're going to have to grind her like a hamburger.
See, that's a different couple.
Oh, you all right, dude. Look, they're holding hands.
They kiss. When they got by the pole.
That's the skin. That bitch is ugly as hell.
Why the fuck did you kiss?
The other one was bad, though.
Yeah, the other one was fine as hell. She was with an ugly-ass bitch.
Yeah, they did that on purpose, man. That's why one was laughing, the other one wasn't.
Oh, yeah, they just thought it was
they
funny.
They did that on purpose. What was this coming up?
Because, you know, they've never met us, never talked to us before, but they just still want to insult us, you know? It's good, though, man. Because, you know, it's because they seen this.
Yeah, yeah.
The only reason, because they hate this. It's like that scripture in John we just read. You know what I'm saying? They love the darkness more than the light.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They rejected the light. Yeah. They reject truth.
They hated the men of the Lord too. They despised the men of the Lord. They were not happy.
And we are not worried about these people.
Man, at all.
What's up, Esau?
Yeah, what's Esau?
Look like he got his shit blown out. He's really walking like an asshole. He just got plowed.
Oh, shit.
I had a scripture I was going to bring out, too. I got some. Hey, this is the Spirit just brought this one out. I opened it up on accident. Amos 8 and 11. Behold, the days come, save the Lord God, that I will send a famine in the land.
You said accident. Ain't no accident, bro.
Well, not a famine of bread nor a thirst for a water, but a hearing of the words of the Lord.
That's the Spirit one, that coming.
Yep. And they shall wander from sea to sea, and from the north even to the east. They shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Lord and shall not find it.
Shit.
Go ahead.
We ain't gonna be out here. You think anybody think we're gonna be out here teaching when there's fucking tanks rolling up and down the street, you out of your goddamn mind?
Hell no, because they're gonna lock you up.
Damn right. We're gonna be shut down then.
Yep.
We're gonna be at home getting drunk, being happy and merry.
Yeah, I'll be happy on that day.
Damn right. Seeing people and hearing people in distress.
And then they be talking anguish. About, oh, you was right though.
Look, right,
you was right,
right
though.
Right.
Like, shut up, bitch.
Too late for that.
Yeah, too late. I don't want to hear that shit.
Put it in your mind. If you can judge that bitch at that moment, if you want to chop her head off then and there. Or anybody, you know. Because the scripture does say, come not near a man that has the mark.
Yeah.
But slay the ones that don't, you know. Let me just get this to you.
Ezekiel might as well just start a four.
Right.
We always see that number 7 fire truck.
Completion. This is our instruction book.
You get it? Yeah, the fire, number 7.
Fire.
Be a complete destruction.
It's gonna be a complete destruction.
It's gonna be the perfect flame.
Right.
I think you quench it.
Yeah, ain't nothing to check for.
There you go. This is Ezekiel 9:4. And the Lord said unto him, go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem.
Remember, Jerusalem's a people before it's a place. People are like, y'all ain't in Jerusalem.
Yep.
You fake-ass Israelites.
Right, right. And set a mark.
You heard that.
You hear it all the time. Especially if the word Jerusalem come up.
Yeah, every time that we're, oh, this ain't Jerusalem.
And set a mark upon the foreheads of the men. Of the men that sign and cry.
Hold up. You sure didn't say the women and the queen, the goddess?
It says men.
Just say it right
and
there.
And set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sign and that cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof. No, there wasn't no women in there. No, no transsexual or LGBT, whatever you call that shit.
He got one of them trick Bibles.
Anybody got some tissue? Anything? Any tissue? For sure. Let me blow my shit. Oh, I needed this one.
Yeah, I'll get that for you. You want to read the rest of it?
No, I got it. I just have to watch a little bit.
I love reading that scripture. That's one of my favorite ones, a blast.
Okay. I'm reloading. It's 5:9-5. And to the others he said, in mine hearing, go ye after him through the city and smite. Let not your eyes spare, neither hath ye pity.
Yep.
Slay. Oh, slay utterly. Old and young, both maids and little children. And women.
Yep. Yep.
Yep. Yep. Oh, that's the spirit. Slay utterly old and young, both maid and little children and women, but come not near any man upon whom is the mark. That's beautiful, man. That's how the spirit works.
And Psalms 137 walked by us.
Yeah.
And Ezekiel 9.
You know?
Because it's going, man, you think the Lord cares about your little bastard children?
Fuck no.
Hell no. And actually, those were Edomites walking by. That's talking about Israelites.
Yeah.
Ezekiel 9?
Yeah.
That's
talking
about killing an Israelite.
Yeah.
So what the hell is all these fake ass bootleg Israelite camps talking about? Bringing everybody together. The Lord said he's going to kill you. And he's going to kill you, your wife, your grandma, your children.
He's going to kill Nan and Papa.
The Lord has done kill more people.
Young women.
Anybody. Yeah, young, beautiful women.
Yep, yep.
They going to get slayed.
Oh, shit. That's that trick Bible, like you said. Okay. But come not near any man upon whom is the mark, and begin at my sanctuary.
Begin at his sanctuary, meaning starting with them fake-ass high priests. Oh, that's them. That's your boys. Is the rap
video?
The Masharo, Josh, whatever the hell they call themselves.
Whatever the fuck that
shit
is.
They bootlegged ass government, man. Talking about they the government of Israel.
Yeah.
Talking about they the high priest and this and the high this and the high that. What the Lord said, go to you first.
We all got them in our local cities.
Yeah.
Your local, wherever the brothers that's in the truth, that's a great millstone.
What those?
GMS.
Them angels know where they at.
Yeah, they're everywhere. That's right. That's right. That's right.
Just like the scripture said, the eyes of the Lord are upon the seven kingdom. What's that? The eyes of the Lord are brighter than that. Sometimes brighter.
10,000 times brighter than that of the sun.
Yeah.
Then they began at the ancient men which were before the house. And he said unto them, defile the house and fill the courts with the slain. Go ye forth.
Fill the courts with the slain. That's a lot of dead people.
Yeah, right. Look. And they went forth and slew the city. Slew in the city.
Damn. They're killing Israelites.
Esau, what's up, bro?
We out here prophesying.
Hey, how long do you think America will last?
You a great American?
2 years.
You love America?
Of course he do. He was born privileged.
I don't know, man.
You don't know?
Like, in what way? Last in what way?
Huh?
In what way? Like, in what way do...
Who you vote for? You're a Bernie Sanders guy, ain't you? Got him.
Called him. Called him.
Liberal lunatic. What's up, Nisa? Let's see the camera. Yeah, so your kingdom's on its way out, buddy.
Yeah, going to slavery.
Yeah.
Your next memory when you come back into the world, you're going to be born a slave.
Yeah, you're going right into slavery.
You're going to be born with shackles around your ankles and your wrist. Getting your ass whooped.
Really?
That's your future. Seriously. You a biblical Edomite. You're not an Israelite. You're a biblical Edomite. You see, you're not a white man. See, white man's just so those are just names that was given to you for a reason. Yeah. You're not white. You're red. Look at you. You're red. You know, you're a biblical Edomite.
Yeah, let me get a scripture for you.
The Lord
bro.
Hates you people.
Do you believe in karma?
Wow.
Well, this is the Bible, man.
Hey, let me read a scripture.
You know, we're out here to prophesy.
Yeah.
The Bible.
The Lord hates who?
Edomites.
He hates Esau.
Really?
He hates Esau.
Revelation 13 and 10. Listen, let me read a scripture for you. Revelation 13 and 10. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword.
Future prophecy.
Here is the patience and the faith of the saints.
See, right now the saints, this is what we're patiently waiting for out here prophesying. We're patiently waiting for our power to put the wicked in.
Because your people's been oppressing our people for hundreds of years, thousands of years.
See, not all white people are the same people.
Nah,
you're not the same nation of people.
I can just tell by the spirit that we're not kin.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right. See, we can't sit down and have a beer and drink and kick it together.
Nah,
because our spirits are just like, boing,
boing, boing, boing. Yeah.
Where you going, man?
You can't run.
Eat so much. You can't run from.
You can't run from slavery, bro.
You can't run from a scriptural missile.
Because he knows the truth.
Yeah, that's right. It's spirit. You can't run from a spiritual missile.
Hell no.
It's on his ass now.
Because you can just tell the foul spirit, man. That's Esau all the way.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to be judgmental.
Yeah.
There are people out here judging people. And everybody got to come to Jesus.
That motherfucker was an Edomite.
If that ain't an Edomite, I don't know what an Edomite is.
Look foul.
Yeah.
Just dead spirit.
Just all of a sudden, he come up, it's just a clash of spirits.
Look at this shit. Proverbs hand in hand. That's Proverbs hand in hand. Hey, don't believe in the Bible, man? Yeah, I know that. You know, the scripture says, slow hand, joint in hand. The wicked will not be unpunished.
It was like a demon was in control of that head shake.
Right,
it was
right.
An exorcist. I thought his head was going to turn around.
See, right
backwards.
Now, that woman, she's a fool, man. She's a fool right now.
He ain't even holding her right now.
Right. You don't hold your woman like that.
What the
f- Let her go, bro. These people.
He's on.
You said you believe in the Bible? He shook his head so. I wish we got that on camera.
Read the mic.
He shook his head so furiously.
Right.
I thought
now she don't believe in him. Well, she thinks she got a meal ticket now for self for life. I'm gonna open my legs and get this motherfucker get me pregnant. I'm gonna say I ain't gonna open that bitch's womb.
No.
I hope he does, though. So she be stuck with that baby in the family. I hope she does get her reward, man. Nasty bitch.
Lord works in mysterious ways.
That's right. That's right. He think he got him a black queen. I'm getting my color back. Fuck that. I read the Bible and I saw that Esau, I saw it. And I saw them fools out there teaching that.
That's what Esau. Esau got a Canaanite woman.
Yeah, and he still lost their color.
Yep. Then he married a Hittite woman, didn't he? Seems a Hittite woman.
Just Isaac and Rebecca.
Yeah, they told him, like, you do not get with the goddamn heathens.
You leave them nasty bitches alone.
Yeah, leave them hoes alone.
They tried to tell him.
He did exactly the opposite. So that's how you know Esau ain't no good. He didn't got no respect for his parents.
Anybody that can lay down with them heathens and come up with Amalek, man, you know that's some foul shit. You know what I'm saying? Can you imagine that wound that pushed that shit out?
Could you imagine a baby being born of an Edomite and a Hittite and a Canaanite? I mean, what monster will come out of that? And they still do that. Because you know the Rothschilds, they have sex with Hamite women, and then they get dark-skinned babies, and they put them in control of all them little African countries and shit.
Yeah.
They get put up their puppets.
Yeah, that's how it works.
Or they'll have sex with any heathen nation, and they'll get, a half-breed child and put them in control of a country.
Yeah, he's so probably in China, Japan.
They're everywhere, man.
Yeah, literally, he is everywhere.
That's why in China, because the Mongols conquered China. with Kublai Khan. Kublai Khan.
Right.
How you say his name? Kublai Khan. They conquered China, and those were Edomites. Those were white people.
Devils. Shit, that's why they built that great wall to keep them motherfuckers out.
Yeah. You know? They built a big ass wall.
Built a big ass wall.
They the fuck out of here.
Should have been reading prophecies because Esau built planes.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Shit.
Oh, yeah, your boy Donald Trump talking about building a wall to keep the Mexicans out.
Yeah, Donald's going crazy. He hates them. He hates Israelites.
He sure does.
He hates Israelites. That's all I can say. I ain't going to say Matt. He hates Israelites. Period. That's a crazy motherfucking bugged out nigga, boy.
Yeah.
Donald Trump.
Them people, they fall for Donald. They in love with Donald Trump.
He said he gonna make America great again.
Yeah, cause you know, people, they don't know which way to turn. Cause they don't have no faith in the Most High, so they gotta put their faith in a man.
Well, that's their fault.
You know?
That's their fault.
You know, Donald Trump pretending he's a Christian, Presbyterian, claim, said he never had a drink of alcohol in his life. Man, come on, man. Yeah, bro.
What the fuck, bro?
Come on. He's a billionaire, never had a drink of alcohol. Right. Okay.
What the fuck?
Yes, sir.
Oh, shit, let me find the scripture.
I seen the pictures of him with his daughter on his lap, staring into her eyes like he just got done fucking her.
I won't doubt it.
His daughter's fine as a motherfucker, boy. You know,
here you go. Oh, you got something, bro?
Oh, yeah, Donald Trump be having them fine-ass women.
Yeah, he's a billionaire. He's a billionaire. He better. But personally, I don't believe he's really popular. I believe he's a big faggot, man.
He's got to be.
He like them animals and men. And mobikes. He like mobikes, too. He like going to the Philippines and they got the
little
boys.
Esau loved the islands over there, Asians.
That's right, man. They love them, man.
They love them. That's where all that torture and shit's going on. Down in like Thailand. I've been to Thailand. That's one of the most disgusting places I've ever seen.
Oh, man. Thailand?
They got a whole section in Thailand. I was up at Pattaya Bay. The whole city, pretend this whole street, every building was a whorehouse. That's Thailand. Every building is a whore. I'm not exaggerating. For miles and miles, as far as you can see, number of whores.
I would have worked the whole street.
No, we did. We had contests to see who fucked the most whores.
Right.
We was running trying to get to the next one. But they had a whole section that you could go to that was nothing but little boys.
Oh, don't even tell.
And you see all the Edomites walking around holding hands with little boys.
And the
military people, they told us, like, that place over there is off limits. You ain't allowed to go there. And then when you go by there, you see why you wasn't allowed to go there.
Right.
They try to keep that shit hidden.
Here you go. This is Deuteronomy 17 and 14. When thou art come unto the land which the Lord thy power giveth thee, and shall possess it, and shall dwell therein, and shall say, I will set a king over thee, like as all the nations that are about me. Thou shalt in any wise set him king over thee, whom the Lord thy power shall choose. One from thy brethren shall thou set king over thee. Thou mayest not set a stranger over thee, which is not thy brother.
Like Donald Trump?
Donald,
probably have some bugged out camps
Donald Duck.
Teaching that he an Israelite.
Donald Duck. Donald Trump. Donald Duck. What's the duck cartoon where the one of them was
Duck rich? Tales.
Duck Tales.
Oh, that's Duck Trick Duck. The richest duck in the world.
Right, that's Donald Trump. Donald Duck.
Hey, that was my shit, bro.
Duck Tales.
Watching Duck Tales.
Yeah, for real.
Cause that really sparked my mind about archaeology and ancient mysteries and shit. Had me wanting to go out on an expedition.
DuckTales. DuckTales.
Yeah, teaching little kids how to be greedy. Scrooge McDuck. He was a greedy motherfucker.
The child is naturally greedy too.
Yeah, children
are
naturally.
Natural. Just, you know.
Just everything's mine. They go through that that's mine phase.
Ain't paying attention to the toy all week long until they see another kid touch it.
Then they want it.
Ah! Give me my toy!
That's why you gotta teach your children. You can't just let them raise up naturally. Because you'll hear people teach that foolish doctrine of Egyptologists be teaching. You got the truth in yourself. You just got to listen to yourself. And yourself will teach you.
Shit.
Like, you out your goddamn mind.
Shit.
You got to listen to your inner self.
Right.
No, you got to listen to that ass whooping.
Listen to the man with the bowl.
Exactly. Go ahead.
19 and 2. A fool have no delight in understanding, yep. but that his heart may discover itself.
Wow, yes, wow. That was on time. His heart may discover itself.
Aren't you just saying?
They, you hear that madness all the time.
Yeah.
All the New Age people, the Egypt people say it,
yeah.
the pagans say it,
yeah.
the Buddhists say it, the Hindus say it. Listen to your heart. Even the Christians say it.
It's all over Disney Channel.
Oh, the Disney Channel, that's hard. Bugged out.
And it mainly be talking to girls, too. It mainly, like, they be having little princesses shows. It mainly be
And it's always the woman that schools the man, that teaches him how to open his heart up, and to listen to his heart. That's some real life faggot shit out here.
Right. Oh, you got Proverbs 18.
Proverbs 18 and 2. That's easy to remember. Proverbs 18 and 2. What's after that? Is there more, probably more juice after that?
Wicked cometh, then cometh, Proverbs 18 and 3. When the wicked cometh, then cometh also contempt. And with agonomy approach.
Agony? What's it? Oh, well, that's a fucked up word. That means having no knowledge. Ain't gonna be. I'm pretty sure, yeah.
Alright, the words of a man's mouth are as a deep water, and the wellspring of wisdom as a flame.
You see that? Read that again.
The words of a man's mouth are as deep waters, and the wellspring of wisdom as a flow of the brook.
Ain't that what we got out here? The rivers of living water?
That's right.
These people, they like a broken cistern that can hold no water.
No. That's
good. You know, we got the water pitchers, you know what I'm saying? They got fluoride water. You go.
It's not good.
Tulip water. They got tulip water.
Right.
Go ahead.
It is not good to assent the person of the wicked, to overthrow the righteous in judgment. A fool's lips enter into contention, and his mouth calleth for strokes.
Gotta open his mouth if he don't agree with you, man.
Oh, because he knows everything.
Yeah, can't teach him nothing.
I mean, ain't never read a history book in his life.
Right.
He's an expert on history.
Never read the Bible in his life.
But he's an expert on the Bible.
That's right.
Expert,
that's right.
You know, he knows that's everything.
Right. That's right.
That's
he went to church all his life, though.
And not only that, he's never read the Bible, and he'll even tell you he never read it, but he knows more than you.
Yeah.
And then the people that would be with him, they'll all take sides with him.
That's right.
You know how many times we have fools take sides with fools?
All the time, bro. We've been witnessing for years.
And we can prove them wrong left to right on this and that, boom.
Show them right out the Bible.
And they still don't believe it.
That's right.
The Lord himself will come down. They'll be like, you ain't the Lord.
That's called some bums reading. That's called some motherfuckers on the streets wearing dresses reading.
But if we was wearing a tuxedo or a three-piece suit.
Yeah, right.
Had a Rolex.
With a big-ass ring on.
Yeah, big glitter.
Blinging and shit.
Then they probably give us money then.
Hell yeah.
We get even richer.
You know what? That's what I'm going to do, too. I'm wear my Rolex out here and see what's happening then. Nah, I ain't going to come out here clean. Man.
Hell
no. I ain't trying to look like a fucking.
You ain't actor. Never. I don't even own no dress clothes. So-called dress clothes. To me, that's the clothes of a servant.
Yeah.
You know.
I still have all my fly shit.
I got a precept.
I still have all that fly bullshit. I don't wear it. Yeah. I ain't gonna wear it.
This is weird. Y'all said fools take a side with fools.
Yeah.
Skip to verse 9.
Oh yeah.
He also that is slothful in his work is brother to him that is a great waster.
Yep. That's how they do it, man. You see that time and time again. The fools always take sides with a fool.
A fool.
Damn, fucking study.
Yep.
Study. I mean, that would
you
never
just say the word slothful.
Slothful.
Yep.
I mean, just to say the word research, they'll look at you like you're stupid.
Huh? Right. Research.
And then if you said to Google something, oh, that's the internet.
Right.
Like everything's on the internet now. You know. But,
what? One dude came out here. Had a degree in education.
Yep.
And the other one that came out here not too long ago had a degree in philosophy.
Yeah.
Or whatever.
It was.
And they couldn't even tell you what the words mean.
The guy didn't know what philosophy meant, but that was his major.
Right. And the other one was an English major.
Yeah. Oh no, that was three different ones. The English major didn't know what English meant.
Right.
You think that's the first thing they would teach you?
Right. Exactly.
You're an English major, but you don't know what English means.
The motherfucker was like walking out. It was a brother too, with garb, and everything.
Oh yeah, he just graduated. Yep. Was you here?
No.
proud as a motherfucker, man.
I'll never forget that one.
He walked off with his head down.
On the channel.
He walked off with his head down.
He did, didn't he?
Yeah.
He felt like you. He probably threw that diploma in the trash.
Yeah. Because I'm sure it ain't doing him no good.
Hell no.
Because my dude I graduated with went to Japan. After he went to Japan to be a teacher. And some reason why he's back here after like 12 years.
But if Japanese don't fuck around.
Right, and he can't find work here, man. This motherfucker was a teacher for years over there in Japan.
You go to a Japanese college, they might actually teach you something.
Hey, check it out, man. The dude, his wife, threw him out and said, take the children with your ass. Take that evil seed with you.
Damn.
You know, and he a Jake. He a Jake. That was one of my best friends growing up, man. Kevin McGonagall, man. Anyway, but he's back here with his two sons that he had with the Japanese woman.
Oh, yeah.
You know? But still, he can't find no work teaching that. And if he does, it's only part-time work or whatever, you know? These motherfuckers getting these degrees and shit, ain't they? They're useless now, man. Useless.
They are useless.
Useless.
I mean, it's a useless. Useless. This is a scam.
You're supposed to use an education or some type of knowledge to be self-sufficient, you know? Instead of depending on this motherfucking nation.
But the main thing with these colleges, though, is not education, it's indoctrination.
Indoctrination, there you go.
It's indoctrination. I mean, everybody knows that all the history professors and everybody, they got their little secret societies, and their job is to withhold information. Because if you don't follow the status quo of the college, they'll disown you. They'll kick you out of the school. They'll fire you.
They're called gatekeepers. They prevent the truth from coming in, and they just...
Like, there's this one scientist, I forget what college it was, a scientist. He did a study and research, following the scientific method and everything. And he was trying to date some dinosaur bones or something. He's like, these ain't no more than, you know, 5,000 years old. He done went through it over and over again, kept getting the same results.
Right.
And he's like, look, these are like 5,000, I forget the exact date, but it was like in the thousands. He's like, these are only like 5,000 years old. And they fired his ass for it.
Got him up out of there.
They're like, that's the wrong answer, buddy.
Yep.
They still holding that Christopher Columbus shit.
Oh, man.
Because, you know, they've been coming out with more and more proof lately. They're, you know, there's been people over in the Americas. Like, they found them Roman artifacts up in Canada. That they found a Roman gladius. And the colleges won't even recognize it. You know?
Found all them Hamite heads up in Mexico.
Oh, the Olmec heads.
Hamites.
Yeah.
And they got the niggas saying that was them. They saying they got the Israelites saying those heads is us.
Yeah. Oh, they
Hamites.
That's
heads
crazy.
Is Hamites. They look. The hand look like a Hamite.
Yeah, they don't look like Jake.
Mm-hmm. Look at this.
Ha. Hey, what about that book? Yeah, that one book, The Lost in the Atlantis and the Amazon.
Yeah.
How they found proof. Oh, and half of those artifacts got confiscated by the government. Did your boy found down there in South America?
You find anything, they're going to take it from you.
Yeah, they're going to take everything.
They're going to try and take it from you.
They don't want you to know the real history of the planet Earth. That's why they always tell you in the colleges, they'll teach you that King David never actually lived. Oh, he was just a mythological character. But every other king from every other nation lived, though, right? You know what I'm saying? But King David, he didn't live. He was a mythological character. Solomon was mythological. But Moses was mythological.
Right, but they'll tell you Caligula was there, though. They
Caligula. Oh, they love some Caligula.
They love some Caligula.
And that's funny that you say, I was just reading an article, and they said that Caligula, even though he was a foul, he was very vile. But they said the Roman people actually liked Caligula because of the way he treated the elites.
Like shit.
He treated them like shit. You see in the movie, he taxed them. Yeah. He'd fucking fuck their wives and everything.
He
prostituted.
Right, yeah.
He prostituted their wives.
Sure, yeah.
And the people loved him for that.
Damn right.
But that's why they killed his ass too, though. Caligula. That's a crazy son of a bitch right there. He takes the gold, bro.
Caligula's probably he's back now somewhere.
Oh, Caligula. I don't know who that could be.
McCain?
Nah, he ain't bad enough.
Oh, right, he ain't up high.
Caligula was getting it, man.
He's probably one of the princes. Probably one of the queen's sons.
Maybe it's George
Harry
Bush. Could be.
Because he's high. Caligula's a power. Power.
He was like a jokester too, though. Who knows, man? Between him, I think between him and Elagabus, those were the two craziest Roman emperors. Elagabus, this motherfucker used to hold lotteries, right? This dude was crazy. The trainee emperor, he held lotteries where you could you win a lottery, you win a chest, right. You might win a house in the lottery, or you might win a dead dog.
Right. What?
Yeah.
What? I gotta read on this.
Oh, yeah, and he would take lottery tickets and throw it out in the crowd,
right.
And the people would scramble trying to get him. And while he was throwing lottery tickets in the crowd, he would also throw poisonous snakes at him.
Oh shit! That's my man.
And he's a grandson of Septimius Severus.
That's my man.
Dude was nuts, bro. Throw poisonous snakes at him. Yeah. Oh, he tricked people in there some rooms, like, come into this room. We got a surprise for you in here. And they go in the room, and there'd be lions in there.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Yeah. Same shit's happened all over again. Like, assassinations and shit are starting. Like, with the Supreme Court judge was assassinated.
Oh, yeah, they just kept murdering Scalia.
This ain't no more ancient Rome.
And I was it'd be on the internet and with my friends and family telling everybody, I'm like, they murdered him. They're like, no, they didn't. On the news, they didn't say they murdered him. It was on TV.
Right.
You serious?
Right.
What, you stupid? It's like they found a pillow over his head. He was going hunting with the secret society.
And the autopsy was ordered not to be performed.
Right, with no medical examination whatsoever.
That's right.
Come on, man.
It's all common sense.
If you can't figure that out.
Right.
You know.
It's America, man.
You're just dumb, man.
It's America. You better expect the worst.
What do you do with somebody like that?
Right.
What do you say to somebody like that? You don't say nothing.
There's going to be more assassinations. We're going to hear about more, man. Because if this happened, it was at a high degree back then in ancient Rome. It's going to be on shit.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be on steroids now.
Because Because I bet back in ancient Rome, even though we know it was all assassinations now, I bet back then it was covering shit up too. You know, years later, the historians got the truth and
put shit out.
You know what I mean? That's all Rome was assassination. Caligula killed Tiberius, they said. That's how he became, they show you that in that movie, Caligula.
And all this talk now about them talking about assassinating Trump. This
they
is
might
talk
do it.
Coming out now. This talk is starting.
And you got people begging that they kill him.
Yeah.
Please kill this motherfucker.
Yeah. So some shit, we in for a big surprise.
Yeah, they said Trump been wearing bulletproof vests to his...
A lot of motherfuckers better be wearing. Because the people gonna turn against them anyway, because people losing faith in their leaders.
And that's why when Septimius Severus became emperor, he got rid of the Praetorian Guard. The Praetorian Guard, the guys who wear the purple, and they protect the emperor. They're the ones that kill Caligula eventually.
Right,
pretty much Praetorian Guard are the ones who selected the emperor. If you got out of line, didn't do what the elites wanted you to do, they'd kill you. So what Septimius Severus did, he became emperor. I think he actually killed a lot of the Praetorian Guard or got rid of them. And then he got his own people who he knew was loyal to him to stay around him.
Yeah. Same shit going
on. So he was smart. He knew this shit was not safe.
Right.
And he was ruthless. That's why his name was Severus.
These goddamn devils are something else. These people ain't trying to be informed on who their enemy is and how the enemy works. So they're going to be caught off guard, man.
That's good for them.
Yep. Be caught off guard.
These people are clueless, man. They live in fucking fantasy land.
This is Isaiah 48:22. There is no peace, said the Lord, unto the wicked. Simple as that. Slick and sly that devil is.
Oh, that's why the scripture said he's gonna be on his belly all the days of his life.
Mm-hmm.
Just slithering around.
In that dust, boy. In that dust.
He's a low life, a piece of shit.
He's gonna be where he belongs. Goddamn Esau.
Ain't nobody, he's a base man. What's that scripture? Isn't that, we used to bring that all the time.
Job.
Yeah, Job. He's a base. Isn't that Job 30? I think it's Job 30. It's been a minute. Children of base men.
Yeah, that's in Job 30. What do I have here?
I don't know how I remember that.
Job 30 and I'm gonna start at 1 because I like
reading. Yeah.
30 and 1, but now they that are younger than I have me in derision, whose fathers I will have disdain to have sat with the dogs of my flock. Yea, whereto might the strength of their hand profit me, in whom old age was perished. For want and famine they were solitary, fleeing into the wilderness in former time, desolate and waste. Who cut up mallows by the bushes and juniper roots by their meat. They were driven forth from among men. They cried after them as after a thief, to dwell in the cliffs of the valley and the caves of the earth and in the rocks.
That's Esau's natural habitations and caves. That's why Mount Seir was like a desert wasteland, nothing but caves. It's all rocky. You know what I mean?
Yeah. 6 is America. To dwell in the cliffs of the valley.
Well, yeah, because now you see that they turned Columbus right here. This area used to be a beautiful forest, right? They chopped all the trees down and replaced everything with rocks and concrete.
Right.
Just pretty much some artificial caves.
To dwell in the cliffs of the valley. Valleys. See, America ain't nothing but a giant valley.
It is
In now, the caves.
We in the Ohio Valley.
Yep. Ohio Valley. Yep. In caves of the earth and in rocks. And rocks.
The skyscraper ain't nothing but a big ass artificial mountain. Artificial caves built in it.
Mm-hmm. And the bushes they prayed under the nettles they were gathered together. They were children of fools. Yea, children of based men.
Base, and that means base means low. You mean just like a low life. They were dirt.
Right.
Oh, that's what it says right here.
They were viler than the earth.
Valor than the earth. Meaning, you know, they just like they're like dirt. You know when you say people that you like dirt to me.
You ain't
shit.
Right.
You're filth. When you think of something filth, that's something that's dirty, like dirt.
Ooh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Based men. Oh yeah, that was it on my
mind. Oh yeah. Yeah, I might as well get over the diet. Go ahead. Oh yeah, that goes right with it.
Fornicator, a vain person as Esau, who from one morsel of meat sold his birthright.
Right, because you seen that Edomite that just came up and talked to us. You seen that foul spirit on him.
Yeah, he thought he was going to come with his wisdom. That's why the motherfucker didn't open his mouth and took off.
I mean, I just one look at him, I just know everything about him.
Everything, bro. That's right. Piece of garbage. And we're going to treat him as such, too. In all the most. I mean, we're going to get down, boy. We're going to get busy.
Man, we just read it. The Lord said whoever leads into captivity will go into captivity.
Yep.
So the Lord ain't no liar.
9.
Man, he saw that bad.
Yeah, I got Obadiah right here.
He got it bad.
Yeah, I'll just go straight to the end of it. Obadiah 1:18. And the house of Jacob shall be a fire. In the house of Joseph, a flame, which represents, you know, the 12 tribes of Israel. In the house of Esau for stubble, and they shall kindle in them and devour them, and there shall not be any remaining of the house of Esau, for the Lord has spoken.
That's their latter end.
That's the end of all these devils. They're going to get burned up.
That's after that 1,000 years of getting your ass.
Oh, yeah, first you're going into slavery,
that's right.
And you get burned up.
Mm-hmm. They got to go through a horror movie first. They got to go through horror first.
They going to be sleeping in a bed of maggots and lice.
They're going to be tired, boy. They still have to work. They ain't going to get no sleep.
they get a rest on the Sabbath.
That's it. And even then, their minds is going to get tortured.
Yep.
Because they're going to have to think about tomorrow. So they ain't going to get no rest. None. Because ain't nothing worse than have to think about shit all the time, man. That you don't want to think about. You ever had a song stuck in your head that you don't want to fucking hear? You know how much torture that is? Shit.
And King David was a man after the Most High. You can't say what we're saying is evil. King David was a man after the Most High's own heart.